this business of birds and cats, I mean, there have been birds forever, and there have been cats effectively forever. Do you know why this sort of has become an issue in the last, I don't know, relatively few months? Years or even relatively few months?
Well, over the past few months and even then within the last year, there's been a heightened sense of awareness about this due to a couple, well, one specific study that came out recently where they actually put cameras on cats and were able to follow some of the cats and were able to document some of the predatory factors of cats as far as their impacts on birds and small mammals. I think it's been a situation that's been around for a long time. People have had cats here in the United States and around the world for a long time. But I think it's just now becoming, as we are beginning to see more and more bird species decline, and we're becoming aware of those declines, we're looking at all different problems from birds flying into windows and window strikes, and certainly cats ranks high amongst them.
Are there any particular species in Vermont that you see as being more vulnerable to cat predation than others?
A lot of the species, cats often prey from the ground.
Right.
They can prey at a higher level from a porch deck or something like that. So a lot of the birds that you might find, a cat gets, are those that spend time on the ground. If you have a bird feeder and you've got seeds falling on the ground, there are a bunch of birds like juncos, which often will use our ground feeders and will feed on the ground. So they're a little bit more susceptible to cat predation.
And what about ground nesting birds? Are they more?
They are, but a lot of our ground nesting birds often occur in forested areas, and so there's that interface when you have cats present. There are ground nesting birds also that nest out in grasslands and haylands,
right,
and in shrublands as well. So they can be, if there are cats present and the cat's a wary hunter, they certainly can be in trouble.
But the cat is there any part of any kind of area where the cats are a greater problem for birds? For instance, is it more likely to be in rural or in urban, suburban areas, or is there a difference?
I think, this is something where, urban areas, suburban areas, you have higher concentration of cats.
Right.
So because you have more cats, you're just going to have probably more of that cat-bird interface. And so it can be more problematic in those areas. You start getting out into the more rural areas and into places where you just don't have the cat densities, then that probably diminishes to some extent. But a skilled cat at getting birds can still very much impact local areas. They did some work over in the Adirondacks where they were showing these smaller developments that kind of crop up, that the impact that cats and other human-related pieces had with the local wildlife increased even with only a few homes in certain little developments.
Oh, because those people brought in cats because, and it increased the density.
And you just have that, the cats and the range of the cats begins to expand, so.
So what should a conscientious cat owner do? Someone who has a pet and wants to keep this cat, but also cares about birds.
It's a tough one, and because many people, obviously cats are a revered pet. And as much as dogs are, people are very attached to their cats. And so it's sometimes difficult to talk to somebody about that. And I think the best way is to just, try to remind them that their cat is better off by being indoors. Its lifespan is diminished by being outdoors. It may have, that cat owner may feel that cat is at its best when it's outdoors, but it's at its safest. And things like vet bills and all of that stuff can be lower too, because cats are just not running into the problems that they would. They don't get hit by cars. So I would try to kind of explain the situation as best I can in a educated way, and then hopefully that cat owner will make the right decision.
There is some opposition, as there is on every public issue in America. What do you say to those who say that the studies exaggerate the extent of the problem and they discount the importance of some of these studies and talk about other causes of bird problems, such as habitat loss and other predators?
I think from the bird community's perspective, and certainly Audubon's perspective here, we look at bird conservation and the threats to birds from a number of different approaches. So we do look at habitat loss. We do look at window strikes. In fact, there's a whole program we're promoting to have lights off in some of these large cities so we don't lose birds that way. And the cat piece is just one of a broad strategy to try to conserve birds.